So here we are in Keswick on Saturday the 15th of November. We've had a bit of a break recently because funny that we've just not had a weekend free, which seems a bit bizarre in 8 weeks, but we've been away with work to Montenegro and Puerto Banús for a friend's 40th and various other bits and pieces. So here we are 2 months later, but just going out for a quick 6 miler at Walla Crag. It's only about, I think, 400 metres, so it's not a big one at all, but good to just get our feet back out.
And we have already done Walla Crag once before, but it was back in 2007, and Joe has deemed that this round of Wainwrights has got to be done post my operation, which was 2009, so it doesn't count apparently, and we've got to do it again. So that's why it's just
why you're so surprised about
one.
Let's do the Wainwrights since I had a heart attack.
No, it was just let's do the Wainwrights.
Since I had a heart attack.
No, you added that bit on.
Since I had a heart attack.
So two sets of rules. We'll play by Joe's for today. And that is where we're going. Eventually. Come away from the lake now, and they're just heading up through the trees. The start of the ascent.
Pretty view.
Yeah. Falcon Crag just above us. We're making our way over towards Ashness Bridge.
There you go. The autumn colours have popped through. It'd be nice if that sun stayed up on it. It's really pretty. I think we've only just about caught it before. It properly becomes winter because it's a bit squelchy underneath, but it'd be nice if the sun stays out for the summit.
Ashness Bridge. And where we're going? There.
That little pimple.
That's not the summit.
It's still a pimple. Hey, one big rock to scramble up. I think it was just the one though. Was it just the one? Oh, boo. Oh well. Guess a. Mate, do then, that's about the height I am actually, to be fair.
So we've got Catbells, Maiden Moor and High Spy in the distance in the cloud.
Not done them yet.
No, still got those to do. Skiddaw still looking very imposing. And we're heading up above these trees. That's Walla Crag's up above there. Bad view. Yeah. Yeah, Bassenthwaite in the distance.
Derwent Island and Lord Island.
Yeah.
So we just come across the fell. Refreshment break, obviously. Although I don't know why, because that is our peak. Possibly not one of the most stunning ones from this angle. But that is Walla Crag, which I think is 378, something like that.
Yeah.
It's a tiddler. So there we are, the 84th wreck. 84th Wainwright. Done. Well, not done yet. Getting ahead of myself. There it is. And that'd be Walla Crag. All 378 metres of it. Again, I know, but you couldn't count it last time. Very much the view's off the other way, though. Not the other way, but there you go. 84 done. And as ever, we've found a perfect little spot for a picnic. Not a bad view, that, is it? And the treat of the day for me is pork and pickle pie. But I don't like pie, so I'm just eating the pork and pickle. And Macker or some random bird out there will be later on eating pie. So a cup of soup and then we'll be on our way.
There we go, that was our picnic spot. Leave no trace. And now we're off back over here. Yeah, we just stopped lunch for 20 minutes and the weather's really coming in now. Bands of rain coming down through the valley there. So, get a wiggle on. See if we can get back before we get wet. Be a bonus, still sunny over there.
So, I've just decided I've got the sense of humour of a 14-year-old, finding it highly amusing that we are now heading towards Cockshot Wood. At 41, you'd think I wouldn't find this amusing anymore, but it just must be the word cock. It just makes me chuckle every time. He's walked off in despair. Getting closer to Cockshot Wood, though. It's funny, after some of the walks that we have done, then you just turn around and go, oh yeah, I don't even need to zoom up like that because it is just there. Yeah, I think that might be one of our teeniest, tiniest walks we've ever done. But Rick thinks it's perfect, but that's lazy man's talk.
You get a phone signal as well.
You get a phone signal, brilliant. Great. Excellent. Right, probably next stop will be the car park and the pub.
So that was a pretty sharpish descent. Didn't take us too long at all. It was probably about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. We're now just following Brockleback down towards Castlerigg campsite, which I think is just here. We just skirt round past that. And then we head down through the woods, back down towards the lake. Cheeky little uphill section just towards the end.
Always throws in a nice little steep bit. Just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water. It's got the heart pumping. Just going round the side into the woods. And I think we're virtually back at the car then. Just wander back towards the car park. And hot chocolate and Baileys. Possibly with a shot of espresso as well. Just to make the drive back on the M6 a bit more fun.
So, just come down out of the woods. Now we're down. So we're back at the lake, really. The field, and that's the car park over there, I think. So we just head down this hedge line now. Join the path that we set off from.
So we're in the, you could just wait.
Sorry.
No, just 2 seconds. We're in the Twa Dogs, in just outside of Keswick. And that was a quick 6.5 miler. Only took us, what, 3 hours today? Just 3.5 hours.
3 hours, 40 hours.
Okay. So that's quite good for us, nearly 2 miles an hour. Up, down, round, done. Bish, bash, bosh. And back home. So we're just on the Baileys hot chocolates, and that's it for this week. Hopefully we'll be back out again next weekend, but we'll see. Knowing us, we'll probably have lots on again. So cheers. Bye.